Ghosh ma'am, Dasidhar ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
So let's get started without wasting time. So today we'll be talking about three important things as a part of this. So we'll talk about presentation tools, we'll talk about video recording tools, and we'll talk about assessment tools. Okay. So let me share the screen and then let me get started. Okay. Okay, I hope my screen is visible to everyone.
Yes, it is visible.
Right. Yeah, so we'll talk about two presentation tools today. The first one is Prezi, prezi.com. So free, once again, I mean, you also have a premium version, but we would not be requiring that. So we'll go with the free one. First thing is you need to sign up. I have already signed it up. So once you sign up, you will see something like this. And to start with, there are a couple of options. See, here in Prezi, you can also do videos. Prezi video is possible. You can download the Prezi desktop app here. You can see left corner. And then you can do videos also. This also can be used for video recording. But right now, my interest is not that. You can also create some designs like flyers, brochures, all of that could be done. Let's concentrate on presentations. How do I use Prezi to make my presentation dynamic, and also very appealing? So when you look at the presentation, you should say, wow, it's so beautiful, something like that. Okay. So for that, the advantage of Prezi is it has readily available templates. Okay. So you just have to choose a template, whatever template you like, and then start exploring it, customizing it. So let me tell you from scratch. So now go to Explore Presentation Gallery. Can you see one on the right? Explore Presentation Gallery. Let's just click on that. So when you click on that, you can see there are so many templates that are available. So you can reuse them. This symbol means reuse. You can use any of these. You can copy paste. When I say reuse, you can copy paste any of these. Prezi is meant for that. So topics wise also, category wise also, you have whatever you want to choose, you can choose. Right now, since we are talking about education, let me just click on education. And here also you have so many of them. Just for your understanding, let me show you one. Let me open up one and then show you how the presentation looks like. Okay. As I told you, I have not made this presentation. These are all readily available templates. I can modify them. I just have to edit them. That's all. I can make this presentation my own presentation. How do we do it? Let's check it. So first click on this. Let us say I'm going to choose this, the teenage brain. Let me click on that first. So before you do anything, so as you can see, make a copy, create your own. I'll come back to this a little later. So now this is the presentation. Let me make it full screen. So now this presentation is full screen. And then at the down, you can see there is an arrow mark. Means you can go to the next slide. Now I'll just slowly keep on moving to the next slide till the end of the slides. It may take 2 minutes. So in between, I can just speak something to just tell you how it looks like. So let's start the presentation. This is a readily available template. I can modify this as per my own requirement. So let's start. So basically, this is about the teenage brain. Now, first we can talk about, the particular thing, teacher note. You can also include video. You can see it there. And you can now go to video, you can play the video, and then you can go to the next one if you wish, and it goes to the next one, next topic. So, and then comes back to the subtopic. So basically you have a main theme and then topics. Within the topics, you have subtopics. So teacher note is over. Now you go to the next topic and then start exploring more in this topic. So all the subtopics you can explore. So go to the next one. Go to the next one, go to the next one. And once again, videos could be put.
This morning was a typical morning for me.
Videos could be put, photos could be put, text could be put. I'll show you how to put that. Go to next one and go to next one. Go through the video, incorporate any video, come back to the main topic. Second subtopic is over. Now go to third topic, third subtopic. And then explain it in greater detail. You are explaining some instrument, working of instrument or something like that. You can do all of that. You can do all of this. You can do all of this. You can highlight things. You can explain things. And within the subtopic, you can still have smaller topics, as you can see. And include videos, show them, show your audience what you wanted to convey in the form of videos or pictures. All this is feasible. Come back to the next subtopic. And once again, show them something if you wish. So, and this should be the end of this subtopic, and we are left with the last subtopic. Explore this, show them some video if you wish. Explore this. So they're all videos. And then at the end of it, it looks something like that. And this is all about your presentation. Okay. So let me just escape and come back to this. So now you have now seen, so it's not like a typical PPT, you know, Microsoft PPT. You know, it looks dynamic. It looks appealing. It looks attractive. So this is how you can make your presentation, your own class, your own presentation, whatever you want to present. So let us assume out of all the templates, you like this. You want it to be presented in this fashion. So what you have to do first, just click on make a copy. Can you see a make a copy here? Just click on that, make a copy. Now what it does is it copies this template for you. So now see, it is making a copy. So let's just wait for a while. And one more thing is, all of this you're doing online. So Prezi, the beauty of Prezi is that, you know, all of that gets stored. Whatever your presentation is, it gets stored there only. You need not carry any pen drive or something. I'll talk more about it a little later. So this is the main topic, and you can see subtopics also. Now I want to change this. I'll just show you one or two slides, not more than that. So now I want to change the topic. So what is the topic that I want to put? Let us assume I want to make it. So delete, if you want to delete something, just click on that, say delete, that's all. So now let me change this. What I want to make it, I want to make this as ICT. Let me put capitals, cap locks, ICT tools in education. Now you observe that it's bigger, so it's not fitting in. So you can change the size. Can you see that? Now it's fitting into this. You can expand this. You can make it small. It's up to you. So let me just, as per your necessity, you can customize this. The beauty of this is you can customize it. So I feel this is good. Now I don't want this Prezi logo. If you want to put your own logo, your organization logo, you can put it. Let me just delete that. And if you want to insert something, your name or something, can you see here on the top? You have style, you have insert, you have share. I'll go to insert, and you can see, you can insert a new topic. If you are a starter, don't explore this. Just start using the available template as it is, or you can start building topics, building the slides from scratch. You can do that. Okay. So right now, let us see how do we customize the presentation. So let us say you can add text, image, PowerPoint also, you can include PDF, video. We have seen sometime back, I've shown you that we can put a video, right? So let me just put a text. Let me write something. So click to edit text. So let me write something. So then click on that. You want to drag it, you can drag it and then keep it here. Wherever you want, you can put it. So all this customization you could do. Next, let's go to, you know, each topic. So now this is the first topic. This is your first topic. So click on that. And you want to change this, because now our intention is we want to make it as ICT tools in education. So now you can just say, the first slide could be, you know, first topic could be, you want to tell them about all the learning mechanisms. So now you can adjust. Once again, it's going down. You don't want that. This is okay, but now it is not centered. So click that and then make it come, you know, you can just make it come to center. So that's it. So now then go to the next topic. Now, if I click here, you can actually, you know, when I click here, you can see the linking. So you can see the numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Can you see the numbering? Which means that is the order in which this presentation runs. Okay. You can change it if you wish. Okay. No problem. And now let me just show you one more. So the second one, let us say, now here we want to talk about hybrid learning. You can put that. This looks okay. Now I want this to be a little smaller because this is my subtopic. So now click on that and make it a little smaller. Can you see? I can customize it, you know, however I want, however I wish. That's very much feasible. So come to this and once again. And then now let us say you want to talk about online learning. Okay, so this seems okay. No, this not, does not seem okay because it's not in the center. So I'll just pull it. So drag, drop it. So two more are there. I'll just show you this. So I don't, it went into it. So I'll just come back. So click it carefully. You want the center one. So click on that, whatever you want to modify. And then I'll say ICT is set up. So here you will talk about the ICT setup. And the last one, you just want to just go back in case by mistake you come there, just go back to that. And then you can just click on that and then go to this. And then you can edit that, whatever you want to put to the last one. You can just say, so how do you do the delivery of your content using ICT setup? Now that's it. So now, so first slide is over. Now you want to go into the second one. So this is the learning mechanisms. You want to go into it. Either you can you see the left side? So can you can go there from here itself. Let me just minimize this. You can go there from here itself. So click on this or you can click on that. It will take you there. Everything is okay. So now in this, you see there is a teacher note, that is this one, and there are goals, there are standards. So it will go into this, it will go into this in this order. You can see on the left side, what is the order. So now let me click on this. You want to remove this video, remove it. Okay, you want to put your own video. So insert video. And you, if it is a YouTube video, you just have to type in something. Okay, or you want to upload a video, you can upload it. So you can see this here, and you know, you can insert either videos from your desktop or laptop, or you can insert video from YouTube. So that's very much there. The YouTube videos will not be available while presenting offline. For us, because we are not premium users, we can never use it offline. We have to use it online only. But just put the YouTube link or upload a video. So that is feasible, and I've shown you how to do it. So that's about putting the video into it. And once again, you want to put some image. So come back to this, insert image. You can upload, there are free images available. You can use them or you can upload an image from your system. Let me just, you know, upload one image just to show you, you know, that it's feasible. And now you can see, I'm going to put this image here. Meanwhile, let me just erase this. Let us say this, I don't want this in my topic. So let us say I'm talking about this. So, and then, you can see that. Yeah, so images, wherever you want to put, you can put. Wherever you wish to put them, you can put them. So that's it. And then once again, this is one more subtopic within the subtopic. And then you can go to that. So you can go to goals. And then you can modify this. So remove this, add whatever, add the content. If you think it is too much of thing is there, just come back to this. And you don't want these goals at all. Just you can just, you know, click on that and then say delete, so that goals is gone. I mean, so like that, if you think it is too much, I don't have too much to present in my content, you can just delete it, no problem at all. So whatever you want to present, you can present. So like this, you have so many subtopics. You can go into all the subtopics and then start editing them. Okay, so this is how you can insert, as I've shown you, text to images, PowerPoints, videos, PDFs also you can include in your presentation. So once you are done with everything, let us assume you are done. Just click on present. On the right side, you can see present. So you can start presenting. Okay, let me just click on present. And yeah, this is the first one. And then I'll go to the next one. So learning mechanisms, and this is what we have edited. So this is, I'll just stop this because only that much modification we have done. Rest all, it would be the same like earlier. So now you can share this. So share, you can change the backdrop, you know, fill color, all this you can is possible. You can explore it. For first timers, you can just use the templates as it is. As you start using it, you can develop your own things, change the background, you know, work out, you can work on it. It's a beautiful tool. I'm sure you would love that. So now you want to share this presentation to your friends or something, give them a link. Okay, and then when they click on the link, they can go through this presentation, or you can present it right away. So I'll just go back to my home page. So I'll go to the dashboard. So this is all about Prezi. So now whatever is there, can you see? So now I have not changed the name. So I think it's better that I change the name. So I'll just say, I'll just rename it as demo WB day two. So now, so once I rename it, it does not. So now you can see it's renamed. So next time you just click on that, and from here only you can, you know, you can share it, you can give it to your friends, or you can present it right away. So when you just click on the present, as I've shown you, you can start presenting. Okay, now two things. Let me just click on this once again to just show you. Now export, can you see right side, can you see an export? Now this downloading and converting it to PDF, you and I cannot do, for the simple reason that we are not premium users. But we can edit it, we can customize it, we can do anything, we can present it. So let us say you are doing a class with you, doing a session to your students. So in the Zoom, you just open the Prezi window, I mean, or you share your screen, and that's it, start presenting to them like this. So this is free, so no charge, nothing. You make a presentation, you start, you know, presenting the presentation to your students, as simple as that. I also shown you how do you edit that and how do you make changes. Now there is one more thing. You can start from scratch. You do not want to use any templates, you want to start on your own, you can start from scratch. Or you already have the content with you, you have the content in the form of a PPT, Microsoft PPT, which we all generally use. Now you can click on this and you upload the PPT. So you can upload the PPT here. And what it does, so now you can see, upload a PPT, it will take that PPT and automatically it would create a template and then give you the results in that particular template. Okay, so it's up to you. There are so many available templates, you can explore them. I just made one presentation, it will take 1 minute to just show me. So let us say you're talking about IC tools in education. So the first one, you talk about traditional learning, online tools, and then traditional learning, you explain to your students what it is, and then you talk about the online tools which could complement it, because we are talking about a blended learning or hybrid learning. Then you talk about the online learning which we are doing right now, and then you explain to them all the tools that are available, the mechanisms that are there, and then you also talk to them about could you please unmute everyone? Please do not talk. Yeah, let's you can talk about the complete ICT setup, and you can also tell them what all tools are there. You can explain to your students what all things are there. And at the end of it, you can also say that, you know, once we are updated with the technology, you know, we are ready to deliver. So teachers will touch the future and we are ready to deliver. So something like that. You can make your own presentation and you can start sharing the presentation, explaining the presentation to your students. Okay, so this is all about Prezi. So I have shown you how to edit it, how to customize it, how to make it your own, and all these presentations would continue to remain in your dashboard. You can use them anytime, you can edit them anytime, and that's all. So what are the drawbacks? You cannot download any of these. It's not like a PPT PowerPoint presentation where you can download to your system. You cannot do that. Number two, you cannot export it to any other form, PDF and all, you cannot export. Only thing is editing can be done. You can modify it as per your necessity. You can change it and you can start presenting. Okay. And there are so many beautiful templates. Please explore it. I'm sure you would love this. So this is all about Prezi. So this is our, and I also shown you how to share it, you know, to your friends, or start presenting. So you can see, for example, presenting, you can do record video. If you have a, you know, Prezi video desktop thing, you can record video conference. You can do, see, presenter view is not allowed here. Lock means you cannot do that. Only you have to unlock the features. It means you have to buy, you have to become a premium user. I don't want to do that. Share view link. This you can do, share the link. So now you are doing a webinar. You share the, you know, link of this Prezi, they can see, or you can just share the window and you can present it. And export PDF you cannot do, download you cannot do. So add collaborators. You can also add collaborators. You know, yesterday you were talking about whiteboard thing, you are talking about collaborators. So you can add collaborators, they can also contribute to your presentation. So all these features are there in Prezi. All right, so let me talk about the next presentation tool, and that's our own famous Microsoft PPT. So for that, I'll take questions at the end of this. I'll try to talk about the important features of Microsoft, PowerPoint. Tips and tricks, rather. I would not say important features. Very handy features, very useful features to teachers. Okay. So, all right. So, how to use a PPT, Microsoft PPT. You know, I'm not going to do all of that, but I'll just tell you interesting features. Once again, Microsoft 2013, 2016, 2019 have these features, whatever I'm showing. Some of the older ones, 2007 and all, these features are not there. I'll also tell you how can you get Microsoft Office. This is a part of Office. As you know, Microsoft Word, Microsoft PPT, all of these is a part of Microsoft Office. And I'll also tell you how to get it. Okay, let me just do this first. So let me present it. So latest PowerPoint features for faculty. Let's try to explore this. Okay. Let's go to the next slide. Now, before I explain about this slide, now at the bottom, I hope this is visible. Okay. At the bottom, I'm trying to highlight them. This makes it to go to the previous slide. This makes it to go to the next slide. Okay. And third one from the bottom, third one, click on that.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, the screen is not yet visible.
Okay.
PPT screen is not visible.
I got that because I have to share this. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Sorry for that.
Now it's okay. Perfect.
Yeah. Fine. I got it. Yeah. Right. So, okay. Let's explore this. Can you see on the left bottom, you have this first one, which will take it to the previous slide. Second one, take it to the next slide. So this slide. And third one, I'm referring to third one. You can see here. This is a beautiful tool. So most of us would be having a doubt, you know, can we annotate on the PowerPoint PPT as I explained? I want to explain to my students. You can very much do it. Click on this thing. You have a laser pointer. You have a pen. You have a highlighter. Let me use a pen. Now see this. Now I can start explaining things to my students. I can tell them, see, this is the headlamp and this is the side mirror and this is the windshield. And you can also say, you know, this is the rooftop, and you can also start writing it if you wish. So you can just say rooftop of the car. Once again, I'm writing with the mouse. Okay. So you can annotate everything and you can say, okay, we are referring to a BMW car, all of that. Okay. Now you want to erase this, you can erase this. So eraser is there. You can just click that, click it. This goes. Okay. And then come back to this. And you can also use a laser pointer. You don't want annotations to be left on the screen. Use a laser pointer and then say, we are talking about annotation using Microsoft PowerPoint. You can do all of that. And please remember, every time I'm coming here and then going there explaining, you don't want that. I'll tell you, I'll tell you the shortcuts in just three minutes from now. And now let me just erase all the ink on slide. I don't want any annotations. I'll just click erase all the ink. Okay, great. So now let me go to the next slide. And can you see, so there's a picture that I'm showing, and can you see a cat over there? If you are not able to see, so no problem, just click on this zoom and then go there, zoom it, and then you can, so let us say you want to explain something on the screen. In your PowerPoint, you have an instrument, you want to explain it to students. So you can zoom in, as I have shown, you can zoom in and then start explaining, and you could do all of that, and then you could zoom out. So this is very much possible in PowerPoint. And then you can also go to the next slide. And then here also, once again, you have a duck over there. So you can zoom into the duck. And let me just highlight it for you. If you're not able to see, this is the duck that we are talking about. And now let me just zoom in. So let me just zoom in. And then you start explaining this to your students. This is how it looks like, something like that, okay? And then you could simply zoom out. Slowly you can zoom out of this, okay? So, and go to the next slide. And then, so you want to explain something and you can highlight things as I've shown you already. So you say, so this one we have talked about, we'll be talking about it today. And this is the one right now we are talking about. And this already we have covered. And suddenly you realize that, okay, yesterday we had talked about sharing content. So please tell me, what is it? Now you ask some question to your students during the class, and suddenly you realize that no one has responded. So what you can do to just quickly change their diversion, you know, grab their attention, click B, B on your keyboard, A, B, C, D, B. I'll just click B, suddenly the screen goes blank. It's not the end of slideshow, by the way. And then you can start writing, hey, my dear students, follow my class, just wake up, don't sleep. Something like that, you can grab their attention. And whatever you are writing, you know, it is not there. It would not be saved in the PPT. Can you see? I've gone to the previous slide. I've gone to the next slide. Nothing is there. Okay. So that is a temporary thing that comes out. Okay. And then you start. So you can also use a highlighter. I'm not showing you how to use this. And then you say, good LMS you should have. And yesterday we have seen Google Classroom, which is a good LMS, something like that. And then you go to the next slide. And then you start explaining to your students whatever you wish. And you can explain. So you say, your video conferencing, we'll talking about it today. This we have talked. This we have talked already yesterday, sorry. So this we will be talking today, et cetera, et cetera. And then let us say about LMS, you have to do something in greater detail. Or let us say your students ask a question. Could you please explain a little bit more on how does this looks like, or what does LMS, something like that. So you want, yesterday, you remember, we used a whiteboard. If someone asks something, you want to explain it further, we have used a whiteboard. In this Microsoft PowerPoint, you need not use a whiteboard. Also, it's inbuilt. And in a sense, just click on W. It's not inbuilt, I'm sorry. You just click on W. Now, see, there's a whiteboard, and then you can start explaining things. So now you draw something, you explain something, and all of that. And then you say, in the context of the ICT tools, you say LMS and something, and then you say Google Meet. So whatever you want, you can start explaining to your students. Okay. Pictures you can draw, shapes you can draw, all of that is feasible. Once again, I'm doing it with my mouse. So as I told you, you can use the external device also. And once again, nothing needs to be done. Just click on the next, that's all. Now, whatever I have written, it would not be saved. Once again, it is just to explain, give a further explanation, and that's it. All right. Now, if you remember, every time we are coming here and then picking the pen, picking the eraser, picking the highlighter, it does not look good when you're presenting it, right? So there are shortcuts. Very simple. Click on F1. If you want to know the shortcuts, F1. It will show you all the shortcuts right now. For PowerPoint, I need this ink laser pointer. So Control P, change pointer to pen. Control I, change pointer to highlighter. Control E, eraser. E, erase entire drawing on the screen, etc., etc. So I'll just show you. For example, so right now I have a pen. Can you see the pen tool? So you can see the pen tool. I'll say Control P. Now the pen tool is gone, and I want to erase this. Simply, I'm not going there. Please remember, I'm not coming here. And my, you can see the mouse. I can simply say E, erase everything, and then Control I. Let me choose Control I. I can highlight this. Can you see this? And let me put the mouse here. And then once again, Control I, highlighter is gone. And then E, you can erase. So these are the shortcuts. F1. So F1, while doing a PowerPoint, F1 gives you all the shortcuts. Now, another interesting thing that you could do, and I would say most of the people who do webinars, who do online things, you know, they use this feature of the PowerPoint. And this feature is called as presenter view. Now, what is meant by presenter view? For example, as you know, generally PowerPoint, whenever you are presenting as a teacher or anything for a business or something, it should not be, you know, what do you say? It should not be cluttery. There should not be so much of stuff on the slide. It should be very simple. And you should explain more rather. So, for example, let me take this slide. And I have to explain about the LMS tools. And I have to talk about the video conferencing tools. If I list out everything there, it looks clumsy. It doesn't look good. So, now I have to talk about it. Like this, you can, generally PPT, you'll have many slides. And you need some supporting thing, notes, you know, to help you out. Because you're doing live. So if you forget or if something happens, it doesn't look good, right? So for that, come to this last one, click on this, and you can see show presenter view. Last one, click on three dots, come to show presenter view. Click on that. Now the beauty of this is, listen to me carefully, the beauty of this is, when you present your presentation in the presenter view, see right now I'm doing it, I'm sharing my screen, so you may not be able to see it, okay? So when I do that, you know, in the presenter view, what is visible to you is only this part. Is only this part. Whatever I'm highlighting, you can only see this. Okay. Beside it, you know, I have the content, you know, notes. I can make the notes. I have the notes with me, Edmodo, Moodle, Canvas, Google Classroom, VizIQ. It won't be visible to your audience. So right now, can anyone tell me what is visible to you? Can you see only that screen or can you see some content beside it?
Only that screen.
Great, because you are able to see only that screen because I have shared the PowerPoint window. If I would have shared with you the total screen, you would have seen what I'm trying to tell you. Because I have shared with you the PowerPoint screen, let me close the presenter view, hide presenter view. Let me do hide presenter view and let me just escape this. Let me just discard. Okay, let me just escape this. I'll come to this slide. So where do you put the notes? Please do not annotate on the screen. Where do you put the notes? Can you see here LMS? You have this notes you have written for yourself, Schoology, at the down, video conferencing tools, all these notes you have done it for yourself. Okay, and when you are presenting, I'll just show you once again. So when you are presenting, this would come on the right side. Okay, right now you cannot see it because I'm doing it, you know, in the presenter view when I've showed you. So this is all about the Microsoft PowerPoint. So there are other features also, maybe one, two of them I'll discuss. Let me delete all this. I just want one, two slides only for that. Okay. All right. So what else can be done? So these are the simple tips and tricks that you can do when you are, giving a presentation. Okay. Now, do you know that in the Microsoft PPT, we all can record the presentation and present it? You don't want to do it live, but you want to make it look live. So you can do a PPT and you can explain the PPT, narrate, whatever I'm doing right now, I'm narrating, I'm explaining. You can do all of that and you can save the video and you can share the video. This is possible. How to do it? Please come to, so top, File, Home, Insert, Design, Transitions, Animation, Slideshow. Click on Slideshow. Click on Slideshow. Record Slideshow. Can you see one Record Slideshow? Now click on that. Record from beginning. So record from beginning. There are three slides. There can be 20 slides. It's up to you. Record from beginning. Okay, now record from beginning. When you click that, now you can see at the top, you can see record, stop, replay. Record, stop, replay. Okay. And you can also have the annotation tools here. You can use any of them if you want to annotate something. Let me choose one color. Okay. So let me choose any color. So now let me start recording. All right. So now it's getting recorded. Okay. So we are now trying to understand the latest PowerPoint features for faculty. And as you all know, as teachers, we all make use of PowerPoint for our presentations, for our classes, etc., etc. And this is how we can annotate. Annotation is a very important thing, and I can annotate, I can write something, and I can highlight something out of my this thing in my presentation. And this is the, you know, CAD that I'm referring to and all of that. So let me stop the recording. Stop. You can either pause or you can stop. It's up to you. And let me close this. And you can see now whatever annotations I have done on the screen during my recording, it's all there. Okay. Do not worry. Now go to file. Now you want to convert it to video recording, right? So go to export and create a video. Can you see create a video, create PDF, create a video, click on create a video. There are so many quality, high quality and all of that. Ultra HD, full HD, anything is okay. And use recorded timings and narrations. Yeah, narrations it should include. So yeah, it's selected. And create a video. Just click on create a video. That's all. Now at the, so you have to tell him somewhere, you know, it has to save somewhere. So let me save in my documents maybe, and PPT futures. Let me just name it as WB demo PPT record. Okay. Something like that. Okay. It's in my documents. Let me remember that. Now at the bottom, you can see creating video. So it is rendering. So rendering is happening. So just wait for a while till the rendering gets over. Once it finishes the rendering, just go back to that folder and you can start, you know, playing that. I would show you. Once again, I request the participants, do not annotate on the screen.
Now, nowadays,
so it's rendering right now. So just wait for a while. Once it is done, I can go back. And this is one thing that you can do. And the second, the last beautiful thing that I'm going to show you using PowerPoint is you can record your computer screen using Microsoft PowerPoint. This is a beautiful tool. You can record your screen recording is possible, you know, in PowerPoint. I'll show you right away, you know, in the next 2 minutes. So rendering is over. Let me go back to this. Where did we have that? We have it in documents, right? So open a new window. So how did we save that as? We saved it as this, right? So I just want to, yeah. So let me open it and then show it to you. Okay. We are now trying to understand the latest PowerPoint features for faculty. And as you all know, as teachers, we all make use of PowerPoint for our presentations, for our classes, etc., etc. And this is how we can annotate. Annotation is a very important thing. And I can annotate, I can write something, and I can highlight something out of my this thing in presentation. And this is the, you know, CAD that I'm referring to and all of that. So let me stop the recording. All right, I hope you all could hear that, right? So what we have done just now, we could,
No, it was not played actually, sir.
I got the point.
Yeah.
Once again, I'm doing the same mistake again. Why am I not able to share my screen? Okay, I got the reason. I request the organizers, please make me co-host if you can do that. Actually, I'm not made the co-host. So I'm not able
Sudipta
to share. I'm not able to share my screen. I can only share Windows.
Sudipta da. Hello, Sudipta da.
Sir, you please continue. We'll ask the technical person to do that. No problem.
See, I'm telling you the reason. Actually, I cannot share my screen because I'm not the host or co-host. So I can only share Windows. So no problem. Okay. So let me share the. Let me just open it again. Let me share it for you, just to show you that you know, very much it is doable.
Any problem?
Please make Rakeshwaran ji co-host.
Okay.
Because I'm not able to share my screen for that simple reason.
Okay, I make it.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Right, great. So thank you. Okay.
You are a co-host now.
Yeah, thank you. Share screen. Still I'm not able to share my screen. What's that for? Okay, I don't know. This is first time I'm facing this. Okay, no problem. It's okay. All right. So let me just show you that. open with VLC Media Player. Let me pause this. Just give me 2 seconds.
Yes.
Share screen and let me share the VLC thing. Okay. Let me play it. Now you can see the video, right? Let me play it now. Let me play it. Just 27 seconds we have recorded. Let me play it. Understand the latest PowerPoint features for faculty. And as you all know, as teachers, we all make use of PowerPoint for our presentations, for our classes, etc. And this is how we can annotate. Annotation is a very important thing. And I can annotate, I can write something, and I can highlight something out of my this thing in presentation. And this is the, you know, CAD that I'm referring to and all of that. So let me stop the recording. All right, so that's all. So I hope you have seen, you know, how do we do that? Yeah, okay, let me go back to the PowerPoint. Let me share the PowerPoint, okay? Yeah, and we said, you know, sometime back you have seen that, you know, all these annotations are left on your this thing. So click on that, click on these annotations if you wish. And then you can just delete them. And you can see this audio thing also. You want to remove the narrations, you can remove it. And you can do all of that. So that you don't want to change your PowerPoint. Okay. Okay, let me now show you one more feature. Let me show the last feature that I wanted to share with you all. For that, a blank presentation would do. What was that? We can do screen recording using Microsoft PowerPoint. So insert. For that, file, home, insert, go to insert. At the end, you have a screen recording. So screen recording, click on the screen recording. Now you can see once again, at the top it is showing record You have to select an area first of all. You know, you can either choose your entire screen or you can choose a selected area. It's up to you. So let me choose a selected area and you know, let me say I want to record only this part of the PowerPoint and audio is there. And if you have a video, it will show you that. I don't have a video, so record pointer. And as I explained, if you want it to record the pointer, it will do that. So click on record and yeah. And then start explaining things. So as usual, you can start explaining, go to full screen. You can just go to full screen and then start explaining things, highlight things. And this is how we can annotate. Annotation is a very important thing. Presentation. Okay, just 1 minute because I'm using the same thing. Let me pause this. Let me close this for a while. Yeah. Let me close this for a while. Let me go back to the PPT. Let me close this for a while. Don't save. You will lose your recording, no problem. I'll just close. Yes, I want to close this. Let me just give me a minute. Okay, no problem. Let me just. Stop the recording because I didn't stop it, so it's continuing. Okay, no problem. So let me just close this. Don't save, no problem. Just give me a minute. Let me open a blank PPT once again to just show you. It got stuck, I guess. So let me open a blank presentation and let me share this with you. Share screen. Okay, right. So once again, go to insert and then go to insert and at the end screen recording, click on that and record. So first select. So let us say you want to select this entire thing. Okay, whatever you want to select, you can select and then start, say record. Okay. And it's recording. So whatever you want to say, you can say. You just go to Google. You want to type something, you explain something. And your video, your audio, whatever you have chosen, that gets recorded. And let me stop the recording. And recording is done. So this is a recorded file. You can play it here if you wish. So right now, I'll show you, you know, how to once again export it. So I've recorded something just for 3, 4, 5, 6 seconds. Once again, go to file and export, create a video. And just once again, same thing. Just click on create video. Just click on create video. Let me just so screen record dash PPT. Let me save it as something. So once again, you can I hope you can see on the screen. It's rendering, creating video screen record dash PPT. So it is rendering. Here you can do a lot of things. I'll just show you. So you can choose the borders for your video. You can choose. There are so many of them. You can explore them if you wish. For your video, if you want to have a border rather than a plain one, you can do all of that. There are a couple of them. See, you can use this feature also. It's up to you. You can explore this. Let it get rendered. So far we have seen using a PowerPoint, you know, how do we present our things, you know, a lot of shortcuts and a lot of tricks we have seen. And now I'll go back to this and I have to stop this and show you that. So let me just let me go back to Zoom. Stop share. Okay, and I have to, so it's in my documents. And how did I save it? Screen record PPT. Okay, so open it. I'll just show that. Okay, so now let me share this. I've opened the file let me share it in Zoom. Share screen. Yeah, VLC. Yeah, share this. Okay, let me play that. So just now I have recorded this. So let me play that. You can say, you just go to Google. You want to type something, you explain something and your video, your audio, whatever you have chosen, that gets recorded. And let me stop the record. Could you see that? So this is how you can do screen recording. So next we are talking about video recording tools. So this also you can make use of, you know, Microsoft PowerPoint. Using Microsoft PowerPoint, you can you can record your entire screen. Okay, but so next question. Let me share the screen. Let me just share my browser once again as usual. Okay, so now two questions. I'll take two questions. I'll answer two questions first. Then I'll take your questions. Number one, is it free? So the answer is, as most of you know, generally Microsoft products and you know, when you have Windows, genuine Windows license. If you have Windows 10, it comes inbuilt as Office 365, Office app. Can you see Office app? It comes free, number one. Number two, if you have a, as I said, if you have a Microsoft thing for your organization, generally organizations will take a license. If you have that, it is free. Let us say you are an individual, you don't have all of that. I'll quickly tell you, how can you get Microsoft online for free forever? It's not a trail. I'm not talking about a trail. I'm talking about how can you get Microsoft Office online. Office includes, I'll show you what it includes. So for that, simple thing you have to do, just Microsoft account, create, you have to just create a Microsoft account. So account.microsoft.com, first click on that, sign in, create a Microsoft account. You can create a Microsoft account. Just click on that, create an account for yourself. Okay, I'm not going to show you how do you create, but I'll till now I've created some 4-5 accounts for demonstration purposes. So already it's logged in, for example, if you see. So you can create account. It will take 1 minute. It's like your Gmail. You know, it's not like your Gmail also. Gmail will ask you so many questions. Microsoft will not ask you so many questions also. So less than a minute, you can create a free Microsoft account. Okay. Once you have created a Microsoft account, remember the username and password. Okay. This is my username. Now go to Office 365. This is important. Go to Office 365 login. Office 365 login. Click on that. Step one, create a free Microsoft account. Step two, go to office.com, sign in, get Office. So what all you can get? Word, Excel, PowerPoint, OneNote, I'll show you. So sign in, let me sign in. Sign in using what? Using the account that I've created just now. So I'll show you the account that I've created just now. Just now in the sense, I created it some time back. So let me copy this, Control V. Then excuse, yeah. So let me give the password. You're already signed in. Okay, remain signed in with this account. That's good. I want that. Huh. So Office 365. So now can you see? See what all it gives me? It gives me Outlook, it gives me a OneDrive, it gives me a Word, it gives me Excel, it gives me a PowerPoint, it gives me a OneNote. All these for free. Only thing is, all the functionalities would not be there. For example, just to tell you that what we have, you know, seen is correct. You know, you can use annotation and all of that. Recording you cannot do, I'm telling you. I mean, using this online thing, recording you cannot do. But let me add one slide. New slide. Let me present it. Now you can see. Can you see annotation tool there? Can you see annotation tool?
Yes, sir.
So now all this you could do. So now make a PowerPoint online. This is free forever. If you are an individual, personal, you're using it for this thing, use this. It is free. You can do whatever I have shown you except the screen recording. I'll also show you that, you know, it's not allowed. So go back. So in the PowerPoint, okay, in the PowerPoint, just let it open. So now, let me just go to the classic ribbon. So let it open for a while. So insert. Now, can you see there is no screen recording here? Can you see that? So screen recording you cannot do using free Office 365. It is free forever. Only thing is, continuous 30 days if you do not log in, then it will get deactivated. I repeat, continuous 30 days means 30 days, 29 days, you don't go to it, you don't log in, no problem, nothing will happen. 30 days, beyond 30 days, if you do not log in, it will get deactivated. Of course, if you use extensively, that's not a problem at all. Other than that, it's completely free. You can insert pictures, whatever you could do with PowerPoint, annotations and everything you can do. So half of what I've shown you, you can do, except for the recording thing. So now I'm going to talk about the recording tools, so you don't require the recording. If you have a license of the PowerPoint or if you have Windows 10, it is inbuilt in your systems. Happily use them. All the features that I have shown you, you can use it. So that's all. So other than that, you can use Word, you can use OneNote, Excel, OneDrive, etc., etc. So 5GB. When you create an account, you will also get 5GB free OneDrive and all this data. All the data, it gets saved, you know, to the cloud, to your account. See, for example, right now it's my account, something, you know, which I have created free. Just 1 minute it took for me to create the account. Using this account, log into Office and explore it. And by the way, you can also click on this. You can upload a PowerPoint from your system to the cloud and edit it in the cloud. And other than that, you can also, let me click on this. One last feature I'll show and then I'll stop. You can also do collaboration, online collaboration. Okay, which means, can you see at the end, can you see share comments? You can share this PPT to your friends. They can either view it, they can either edit it. So if you are doing a presentation, you know, you and your colleague have to present something to your boss. Now you can both work together on the same file in the cloud and all this data gets stored in your account. Can you see that? It's a beautiful tool. And if you do not have a Microsoft license, as I told you, most of us, most of the institutes will have either Windows, genuine Windows, they'll have. So that's okay. In case you do not have, nothing to worry, create Microsoft account, go to Office 365 login, and there you go. You get a free, completely free. You can utilize all these, not just PowerPoint. You can utilize all these for free. Let me just go back. I think that this is all about the tools. Let me quickly take questions, if any, and then I'll go to the next one. Yeah, maybe 10:56, four more minutes for questions, and then I'll... please share the names of Microsoft versions MS. 2013, 2016, 2019. What I have shown you, 13, 16, 19. If you do not have any of these, please follow what I have told you at the end of it. Create a free account. Use it online. Explore it online. Explore the futures. And you can present it also. So, yeah. Please repeat how we can use whiteboard. It's very simple, sir. Whiteboard mode or blackboard mode. Capital B. Blank. Okay. That gives you a blackboard. Write something on it. That's all. Click on next. It will go to the next slide. W is a whiteboard. Click on that. Explain it. Write something. Explain it. Is it MS 365? Yes, it is Office 365. Yeah, Microsoft tools. Now they are calling it as Office 365. Yes, it is MS 365. Exactly. However, these tools, each one is a part of proprietor based. Absolutely, sir. Saikat Nandiji. That's why I'm telling you. I'm also giving you. And how do you get all these for free? If not all, see, let me be very clear. All the functionalities you will not get. There has to be some difference between a free thing and a premium thing. But annotations, except reading, except screen recording and other things, I think presenter view also is not possible. But annotation and all you can do. As a teacher, I think that's more than sufficient for us if we do not have a license. So nothing to worry. If you do not have a license, it's not that, sir, I cannot use it legally. You can use it legally, by the way, that I have told you just now. Yes, for free. Google Zoom app, for example, automatically enables location of the smartphone. Privacy issues. So, I mean, if you talk about privacy issues, I'm not an expert to comment on that. But I think Google and Microsoft are, I mean, Microsoft, Google, for that matter, you know, they are, it should not be a problem. Original software, exactly. So original software, I've already given you the answer. It's legal. So what I'm showing you, what I'm doing is legal. Okay. Because Microsoft is allowing me to get a copy of it. Okay. Online. It's only online based. Okay. I cannot download anything. I cannot download it to my system. Okay. But if all your data, all your presentations, all your Word documents, it gets stored. Yeah. Okay. All right. Okay. Any other questions? Okay. Let's move on. It's 11. I'll try to. All right. So yeah, presentation tools, we are done. Let's talk about the next one. And the next one is video recording tools. Okay. I wanted to share with you three of them, but right now I'll share only two of them because of lack of time. If time permits, I'll share the third one, but I'll name it APowerSoft. I wanted to talk about APowerSoft. online free screen recorder. On a PowerSoft online free screen recorder. Okay, I'll show you. Just take 2 minutes. So now, what it does? First, let me explain it for 2 minutes, and then I'll show you. You want a free screen recorder. See, there are so many screen recorders. Screenocastic, Screenomatic, lot of them are there. Most of them are time limited. What do you mean by time limited? They give you for free 15 minutes, 10 minutes, half an hour. Okay, you will not get more time. Number one drawback. Number two, some of them will give you more time, but they will put a watermark across your screen. They'll give you a watermark, movie or something like that, Animoto. They'll give you a watermark. You do not want a watermark because your content will get covered by the watermark, even though it's a transparent watermark. That's a drawback. So now, what I'm presenting to you right now is a web-based screen recorder, which means it's online. So when you talk about screen recording, there are two things. One is do it online. Only whenever internet is there, you can do it. You can also have offline screen recorders. Offline means you do not have internet, but you have a PPT. You want to record the PPT and then share it. You can do it using offline screen recorder. Okay. So offline recorders, online recorders. Right now, what I'm showing you is an online screen recorder. So free online screen recorder. Click on that. A PowerSoft is the name. Start recording, download app. Please do not download the app. If you download the app to your system, it will give you only limited things. Don't do anything. Just start recording from your screen. You can just start recording from your browser. This is browser based unlimited recording. You can do this for any amount of time. It would record it. You can save it in your desktop or in your laptop. Simple. No watermark, nothing. No time limitations. A PowerSoft. Let me show you how to do it. Start. When you click on the start recording, it will ask you to download a launcher. It's just 2 MB, I think, not more than that. I've already downloaded it. So let me open a PowerSoft online launcher. Oh, I have downloaded it, right? Okay. I'm not downloaded. Okay, let me download it so that I can show you also. And I have downloaded it right now. And it will install on its own. You know, we need not do anything. So now it's launching on its own. It's just 2 MB, I guess, not more than 2 MB. Let it launch the application. So now, let me change the background. So let me just say google.com. Right. Okay. Now, can you see this? So record button is there. When you click on record button, it will start recording. Okay. Full screen. I want to. Do you want to record the full screen or you want to record a part of the screen? Now you can choose a part of the screen which you want to record. Let us say you want to record only this part of the screen. Let us say it is a PPT you are presenting. You want to record a part of the screen. You do not want the other things. You can choose the region. System sound. If you have a webcam, you can include the webcam. Right now I do not have it, so I'm not going to put it.
Please don't worry about screen. Please share the screen.
Oh, okay. Yeah, just give me a minute.
Please do not annotate on the screen. Requesting all, please do not annotate on the screen, knowingly or unknowingly.
Okay, now can you see the
yes,
controls?
Yes, sir.
Let me explain the control.
Absolutely.
So record, first is record, click on record, you can record full screen, it will record the full screen, region. So this is the one that I was talking about. You can choose the region. So you can choose, let me show you, I think you would not have seen it. So you can choose the region. Okay, see, I have picked up the region on the screen. And is it visible?
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
So system sound, webcam, account. You need not create an account. Don't do anything. It will just save to your system. More settings. If you want, you can explore the settings. All of this. Where do you want to save it? General settings. You can save it. You know, it will tell you all of that. Please explore it. Completely free. No watermark. Unlimited time. Let me just record it for a while. Let me record something. Hi everyone. So I'm just trying to record this, and I can also use annotator. This has an inbuilt annotator, so I can use this and I can annotate something on the screen. So I can write something, and this is the Google. This is I can talk to the Google and then it would type it there. Let me stop the recording. All right. So I have recorded something. Let me just save it. So it automatically gets saved. Let me go to the folder, open the folder. Just give me a minute. Now let me share that screen. Stop share. Now share what? Share. Let me open the file and then I'll show you what I've recorded just now. So this is the one. Open with the VLC media player. Pause it for a while. Now I'll just share it. I've not shared it yet. Okay. Let me play it. So now you can see it has taken that screen, whatever I have shared. You're not able to hear my voice. There is a reason for that. I'm already using one more recorder. I'll talk about it a little later. So two things, it is not taking my voice. So else it will just take it. You have seen the screen recording, your voice 100% it will be there. So that's not a problem at all. Since I am already recording this entire session using OBS, it's not showing you. So that's okay. Don't worry about it. So this is a free tool. Any amount of time you have seen, there is no watermark, nothing is there on your screen. So that's it. Now, number two, second one is a simple Zoom using Zoom app. Okay. In your laptop or desktop, once again, in your mobile, you cannot do that, but in your laptop or desktop, you can record it. You can simply use that. Let me show you how to do it. I have a 3-minute video which I have done to show you. Let me just open that for you. Give me a minute. Day two, Zoom recording video. Okay, Zoom recording video. All right. So let me share the screen. VLC, yeah. Okay, great. Share computer sound, great.
So hello everyone.
All right, now it's a 3-minute video. Just follow the steps, very simple. Assuming that you have a laptop or desktop, how do I record using Zoom app? 40 minutes you can do, no watermark, nothing. This is a beautiful thing. You need not have any students to join the session, nothing. You can just start a meeting. Record your session. I'll just show you. Okay, please check this.
Everyone, so today let's try to understand, how do we do screen recording using Zoom app. For this, you should have logged into the Zoom. So I've already logged in. Now click on new meeting. So click on new meeting. So then it will open up a new meeting. And now you join it. So now here you can see share screen record. So click on the record. And now you can see you have a pause option and then stop recording option. So here also it will show you that it is recording. So now share the screen. As you can see, share, you can just share your screen, click on that, and you can also share the computer sound, in case you want to show something to the audience. So like you play something, using YouTube and all of that, you can share that. That's okay. So share it, and let me minimize it. Now you can start typing something. So Google, so let me just say something. So now you have this. Now you can also use annotate tool available. So now you can start typing something, or you can just use spotlight and then you can say, yeah, this is the elephant that you're talking about. So these are the different types of elephants that we have. And this is the National Geographic channel that
has Zoom has an inbuilt annotation tool, okay, whiteboard tool and an inbuilt annotation tool. So that I'm just showing. Okay, let's continue.
Highlights all the details about the elephants and all of that, and then you can clear all of the drawings and then close this, and your recording is happening. So whatever is happening on your screen, entire screen, you can record it. Now let me stop the recording. So for that you can go to more, you can see pause recording, stop recording. So now you can stop the recording, and unless you close the meeting, you end the meeting, the recording would not be saved. So let me now end the meeting. So end meeting for all. Now when I end the meeting, automatically now you can see convert meeting recording. So now it is converting the meeting recording, and then it would save in my desktop or laptop folder. So now it will also show up where it has stored it. So you can see here, folder is getting highlighted. So today's, for example, today's meeting. So now click on Zoom. So that's the recording that it has done. So you can just open it, play it with VLC Media just to make sure that.
And now you can see.
So now
you have a pause option. So here also, yes. Let me minimize. So Google. So let me just say.
So now you can see that is what we have done, right?
Double. So now use Spotlight and board. So
whatever we have highlighted, you know, all of that is there.
Channel that highlights. And your recording is happening. So what you can record
it. So that's the beauty of it. 40 minutes, continuous 40 minutes. You can do that. And that's the advantage of Zoom. And it has good quality also. You know, the quality is good of the recording. So you can go ahead, enjoy using Zoom recording.
Yeah. All right. So that's about Zoom recording. Once again, if it is within 40 minutes, you enjoy, I mean, with you can do a good job with Zoom recording. It has really good quality. So you can use that. A PowerSoft you can use, and these are all once again online recorders, either Zoom or A PowerSoft. You need to have internet. Okay, now we will see one offline recorder. So Microsoft PowerPoint, you know, also is offline screen recorder, but as I told you, if you want to use the recording feature, then you should have a licensing. I mean, which as I told you, you know, the Windows 10 will have that, or if you buy it, it will be there for your institute. Else, all the other features already you can use as I have shown you. Okay, that's okay. Now, offline screen recorder. Now, let's talk about one screen recorder which is offline, which you can use it offline as well as online. And you, using this recorder, you can also live stream to YouTube, Facebook, and all of that. Okay, the name is OBS, Open Broadcaster Software, completely free. It's an awesome tool. You will start loving it. So I'll show you how to use it. So let me just show you how to use it. Just give me a minute. All right, so Control V. Let me share the screen now. Can you see the screen? Yes?
Yes, we can see.
Okay, great. So, yes, yeah, yes. Now let me play it. It's a 7-minute video. Please go through it carefully. It's very useful. OBS, it will be explained there also. So
number one,
let me just highlight this.
Talk about OBS. This is a beautiful tool. You can do online recording using this. You can do offline recording using this. And also you can live stream to YouTube or Facebook or Twitch. You know, all these platforms, you can also do live streaming free. And you know, this is a very beautiful tool, very, very helpful. Offline recording is possible. Online recording is possible. So let's get started. Let's put OBS. So in Google, let's search for OBS. So click on that and it will show you the first page, OBS, Open Broadcaster Software. So click on that. It will show you the different versions that are available, Windows, Mac, Linux. So whatever you want, you can download it. And I have already downloaded it to my system. So when you actually download it, and then install it, it will ask you a couple of questions. Just say okay, no problem. Some 2-3 questions, and this is how the interface looks like of OBS. So once you open it, something like this pops up on your screen for the OBS. So do not worry about it. We'll talk about it in a little detail. So there are a few things that you can see on the screen. On the top, you can see a blank screen, and on the bottom, top left, you can see scenes, sources. You can also see audio mixer. And there you have two things, desktop audio and mic. Since I'm speaking right now, you can see the mic, you know, indicator being, you know, moving. That's because I'm speaking. And that's about the audio mixture. And apart from that, we also have two more things in the controls. One is scene transitions. Let's not worry about it right now. And controls, the last one, you have start streaming, start recording, studio mode, etc. We will explore a few of these. So start recording. If you click, it will start recording, and it is as simple as that. So to start with, we have to add, first of all, we have to add the display which we have to record. So for that, go to sources, as I have shown. So go to sources and click on the plus button. There are two buttons here, plus and minus. Plus is for add, minus is for remove. Click on plus. It will show you a lot of inputs. So audio input capture, audio output capture, browser, etc. Let's click on display capture. So what it does, it captures your entire display. It's like your screen recording. So it basically captures your entire display on your screen. So display capture you can use. Else, if you want to only capture a particular window, like as we do it in Zoom and Google Meet, so then use the window capture as shown here. So then you can capture only a particular window. So right now, I want to record whatever is coming on my screen. So let me click on the display capture, say okay, and say okay. Now you can see something comes up on the screen. Do not worry about it at all. So we have nothing to do with that. Leave it as it is. So now we have added. Now we have told the OBS that it has to display, that it has to capture my entire display. Okay, now add one more thing. Let's add the audio input. So click on plus and then go to audio input capture. So whatever I'm speaking, it has to record. So click on that, say okay. It will show you the sources. Like if you are using a microphone, headphone, it will show you. Choose whatever you want. Else, you can just leave it default. It's up to you. Say okay. So right now, my video source is given to the OBS and my audio source is given to the OBS. Okay. And so now I can. So this is the entire screen. The black background is the entire screen. Now you want whatever you are capturing to occupy a part of the screen or the entire screen, you can choose it by just dragging it, holding one corner. Okay, so we can do that. So now let us say I want to include the presenter, the one who is speaking during the talk. So now you can click on plus and then go to video capture device, as you can see. So video capture device, click on that. So basically, when you click on that, the webcam or any other source of video capturing that's happening for the presenter, you can it will take that. So say okay. So when you click on okay, it will show you the video of the presenter. And right now, as you can see, yeah, hi, that's me. So click on okay. Now this comes as a small window, so you can drag it, minimize it, and put it wherever you want. Right now I'm putting in one corner of my display. So as you can see, I can put that. But sometimes what happens is your presenter can occupy the space available. I mean, so he can block some things on your screen, whatever is visible, whatever you have written. So far, to avoid that, now you minimize the presenter, put him outside the display capture, so that whatever entire display is being captured, that is there, you can see it properly, and the presenter is also seen, and he is not blocking the capture your screen at all. So this you can do like this, what I have shown. Let's start the recording. So click on start recording. So maybe let's record for 5-10 seconds. So now it's started recording. So now let's just Google something. So Google, and maybe so whatever I'm showing right now, it's getting recorded in the OBS. So I think that should be okay. Let me now go back to the OBS, and let me just stop the recording. So click on stop recording. It has stopped recording. Now go to top. There are a lot of tabs: file, edit, view, profile. Go to file, and then click on show recordings. The first one, file, show recordings. It will show you all the recordings that you have done in OBS. If you are doing it for the first time, it will show you only one, and the name, date and time, when you have recorded. It says with that name. And you can, let's open that, whatever we have recorded just now. Let's see how does it look like. So now you can see now. So I'll just, now you can see the entire screen is there and the presenter is at one corner. He's not blocking anything on the screen. This is what we wanted. You can put it anywhere. You can put the presenter to the top left, top right, bottom left, bottom right. Now you can see what we have recorded just now for the 15 seconds or 22 seconds. So whatever you have recorded, now it's coming up. I'm not switched on the audio, so you're not able to hear what he's speaking over there. So do not worry about it. So it would capture the audio as well as video. Okay. So see, as you can see, it's a very simple tool. It's a very beautiful tool. It's very handy. As I said, you can do offline recording using OBS. You can do online recording using OBS. And also, most importantly, you can also live stream, you know, to YouTube or Facebook, etc. So this is a very, very useful tool. And it is very handy. And I'm sure.
All right. So let me just stop sharing. So that's about OBS. So just to show you the interface, maybe I can. Okay, I'm not able to share the OBS window. All right. Okay, so that's all about OBS. So it's a beautiful tool, as I told you. You can record it offline. You can record it online. Okay. So three screen recorders. You can, as I said, you can also do YouTube live streaming. I'm sorry. You can do live streaming in YouTube using OBS. Right now it's 11:20 because we are running out of time. I'll not do that. I'll make a video of it and then I'll share it with you all later. Not a problem at all. Okay. So that's it about OBS. Importantly, unlimited time, no watermark, offline. You can use it for offline screen recording. Very, very important. Very, very useful. Lot of YouTubers use OBS. You can Google OBS settings, best settings for the OBS, something like that. You will also get the settings, but whatever default settings he gives, if you use it for teaching purposes, it's more than sufficient. Okay, let me pause. Let me stop here now. So three things we have discussed: APowerSoft, using Zoom, and using OBS, offline as well as online. Let me take questions and then I'll go to the last one. Okay, we can, so questions. We can also record via OBS, right? Exactly, that's what I've shown you, sir. Yeah, we can record. But whenever I play some video during recording, the video is not smooth running in the recorded version. How can I solve the problem? StreamYard is getting much popular than OBS. Okay, so StreamYard I have not explored, so I cannot comment and I cannot compare StreamYard with OBS. But OBS, I think it should not be a problem. You just have to tweak around with the settings, Sandeep ji. So the settings you have to just tweak around, and he should be able to get the best settings for that purpose. Yeah. If possible, please repeat OBS for live streaming again. Right now, I'll not do it. Actually, the reason I'll tell you. One reason is we are running out of time. The second reason is, for some reason, I don't know. Today, I'm not able to share my screen. Share my screen means entire screen. I can only share, you know, individual screens, windows. I'm not able to share the entire screen. Don't know what's wrong. It's okay. No issues. No problem. I'll put a recording of it. No problem. Next 1-2 days only I'll do that. No issues. Only live streaming that I'll do. Okay. I think there are no questions. Can we add animation? See, OBS, actually you can do so many things. I mean, I'm limiting myself to how teachers can use it, how we as faculty can use it. Okay. For the delivery of content, you gamers. OBS is mostly used by YouTubers and gamers. They do a lot of things. They add effects, all that they will do. But right now for us, video, audio, and recording, that's more than sufficient is what I personally believe. But you can explore. I'm giving you what tools are there, whether they are paid or free, everything I'm telling you. And as you have seen by now, 99% of what I'm showing you is free. Microsoft also, I've told you how to, you know, use it free. How heavy is OBS software? OBS software, I guess, is maybe less than 200 MB, I guess. I don't remember it, but it's not very heavy. You can just download it. Yeah, maybe around 150, 200 MB possibly. Once you install it, you can use it anytime. So APowerSoft, once again, you could not hear my video in the recording because I'm recording this entire session in OBS right now. So that's why you cannot hear the audio. That's all. Else, everything else is okay. Processor i3 is okay for installing. Yeah, it'll tell you, sir. I mean, I do not know exactly, but it will tell you. I think 32-bit, 64-bit, it is okay. I mean, I think it should accept. Yeah. When I'm sharing PPT, how can I shift it to next slide without disturbing the screen? Just click the next arrow mark, sir, on the screen. So someone is saying 70 MB. So it's less only, yeah. Click on, see, you have four arrow marks, right, on your screen, next to numbers. So you can just click on the next arrow mark, it will go. Okay. Right. Any other questions? 11:24. Else, we will now move to the assessment tools. OBS is really good. Please explore it. It is really good. You can do many things. You can change your virtual background. I mean, you can change your background also. You know, I'm not going to show you enough. You can change the background. Like Zoom, you have a virtual background, right? If you have used Zoom earlier, you can have a virtual background in Zoom. Like that, in OBS, you can have a background and you can remove the background. There is something called as a chroma key. Because if I cannot show you, there is no point in talking about it. So if I show you and tell about it, then it makes sense. So since I am not able to show you, I don't want to talk about it. But just remember this chroma key. Using this, you can remove the background in OBS, like how you do it in Zoom. Okay, let me stop it at that. Let's talk about the last one, assessment tools. So now you have delivered, you have recorded offline, online, you made a PPT, you know, you used whiteboard, you gave the content, everything is over. Now what you have to do, you have to assess the students, whether they have got the concepts or they have not got the concepts. Yeah, how to download OBS directly from Google search, just click OBS download. It will take you to their homepage. That's all. Okay. Yeah. Okay, let me just continue. So now it's time to assess your students. Okay. There are so many things. Let me list out. Yesterday also in the PPT I have shown you. Let me just list out a few. You have GoFormative, you have EducaPlay, you have not EducaPlay, I'm sorry, GoFormative, you have Microsoft Forms, you have Google Forms, you have Book Widgets, you have TestMoos today, and you have gaming platforms also. Today, I will talk about three things because we have only half an hour. I'll talk about three things. Number one, I'll talk about TestMoos first. Number two, I'll talk about Microsoft Forms. Google Forms, not Microsoft Forms. We'll talk about Google Forms in good detail. Number three, I'll do one gaming assessment, Mentimeter. It is Mentimeter. Okay. I'll do this. I think time should suffice. So let me just get started. So let me share my screen. Just give me a minute. Escape. Just go to Google. Okay, let me share my screen right now. Chrome. Yeah, let me share it. All right. Okay, so I hope my screen is visible. Okay, the first one, TestMoos, TestMoos, TestMoos. Free, it's free. The only limitation is only 100 students can take the test. Okay, before I start it, see, when you do a test actually, when you do an assessment, you want the students to write the assessment, you to give the test. And you also want the results to be readily available to you. So it should be auto graded. You do not want to like we do it traditionally, you take the papers and then evaluate it, tick it. You do not want all of that in digital mode. You want it to happen automatically. So these are the tools that can help you, that are handy. Only limitation is if you have essay answers and all, it's difficult. If you have multiple choice, if you have single word answers, and true or false, all of that could be done here. If you have essay, as I've shown you yesterday in Google Forms, like assess in Google Classroom using Google Forms, you can check it manually. I've also shown you how to check it manually. Okay. Other than that, auto graded tests, you know, we can create. Okay, let's get started. Let's use TestMoos. So yeah, limitations of this is per test. For TestMoos, I'm talking about TestMoos. Per test, you can have only 50 questions. Number one, first limitation. Second limitation, only 100 students can take the test at a time. 100 students. I assume that generally, we do not have more than 100 students in one class. If you have another class, build one more test for them. That's all, as simple as that. Okay. This is the only limitation of TestMoos. Else, it is a beautiful tool, completely free. Don't sign up. Nothing is required. You need not sign up. Okay, just start. I'll show you from scratch. So test name, ICT tools test, something like that. Okay, choose a password. Password you should remember. Password you must remember. Okay, you can copy it, keep it somewhere. Create test, click on create test. Okay, so now what it is saying, it is saying, so next thing is this link is important. If you have to see the results and other things, this link is very important. Copy this. Once again, you have to copy your password and this link, Control C. I have copied this. Okay, so bookmark this page and write down your password. Both I have done right now. If there is no way to recover the URL or password, no problem, I have noted it down. Now go to settings, left side, you can see dashboard, settings, questions, publish, results. I'll show you all of them one by one, no hurry. Let's go to settings. So test name is there. If you want, so you can just give some description. This is a test on ICT tools, something, whatever you want to describe it, you can do it. Color scheme, you can choose any color scheme if you wish. Sorry, you can choose that. And there are some options, show all the test questions on one page, show one question per page. This is preferable. I'll leave it as it is. Randomize the order of the questions during the test. Yeah, generally, you know, we use this. Okay, you don't want them to be in the same order for all the students. It's up to you. And score at the end of the test, display the user's score. Yeah, after the test, he should also know how much he has scored. Of course, in results, you can analyze how much he has got, but he should also know what went wrong, how much he has answered correct, how much he has answered wrong. So that's okay. And please do not annotate who can take your test. Anyone, no problem. And how much time do test takers have to complete the test? You can limit, you can give the timer. So let us say 10 questions, 10 minutes. Okay. So how many times can someone take your test? Obviously, you want them to take it only one time, right? What should test takers enter to identify themselves? You know, ID or name, you can write it. So I'll just say enter your name. That's okay. Okay. Because I'll share this link with only my students. I know other than my students, no one will take this test. So that's okay. So save this, no problem. Then go to questions. Now I have to include the questions. Okay. So let me include the questions. Let me just let me stop the sharing once because it's annotated. Let me share it again. Okay, now, so insert. So now you have to insert the questions. Now there are a couple of options, multiple choice, choose one, means only out of the multiple choice, only one is the correct answer. Multiple choice, choose many, which means more than one could be the correct answer. The answer, the candidate has to choose more than one. True or false, matching, fill in the blank. Essay also you can do, okay? Right now, I'll just show you two of them, just for our understanding. So let me choose multiple choice. Enter your question. Zoom has a free time of dash minutes. Yeah. For normal users, okay? You can give the choice. One is, let us say 60 minutes, and there is 30 minutes, and there is, let us say 40 minutes. So three are enough. So I want to remove this. So click on this, delete, click on delete button. This other extra answer would go. What is the answer? You have to give the answer. So 40 minutes, I know it. So I click on 30, but I know the answer is 40. So click on this. That's okay. Show explanation. You cannot show explanation because it's a premium version. Don't worry. I do not want that. No problem. That's okay. Now this is okay. Now click on. So first question is over. Insert one more. Maybe I insert one true or false. Okay. True or false. let me any question, I mean anything that you want to do. Using test to most, I can have a maximum of 100 questions per test, true or false. So what's the answer? As we know, the answer is false, 50 questions, right? So click on the answer, that's okay. Give the points. So 2 marks or 1 mark. So 1 mark I'll give here, I'll give the points here. That's all. Enough for us to understand this. So I'll go to publish. So the question paper is ready. Let us say you have put 50 questions or how many other questions you want to put. Publish it. So click on publish. And you can preview your test if you wish. I'll publish it. Publish. So this is the link where the candidate can answer it. So I'll answer that. So let me copy that. Give me a minute. Control C. Let me just click it in another tab. Okay. So this is the test. So this is how your student can see it. So Rosh, let me add a student name, Rakesh. Let him start the test. Start. So time remaining, can you see the time remaining? Because we have added timer, 10 minutes test. So here down you can see time remaining. Okay. First question, answer is false. Let me answer it true. And Zoom has a free minute of, let me answer it correct. 40. Submit. So now see, immediately it is showing which is correct, which is wrong. And it is also telling him how much he has got. 1/2. So he has got 50%. So that's okay. He can log out. I'll just close this and come back. So this is your admin panel. I hope you have saved it. If or else control V, admin panel, and go to results. Now what you have to do? All this you have done. Tick mark means you have finished. So go to results. Now see, just now Rakesh has taken my test and you can analyze this. So how Rakesh has performed, click on that. You can see individually, you can see, you know, how the candidate has performed. Okay. Go back, or all the 100 candidates, it will show you 100 candidates data. It will show you, okay, here. Right now, it's only one student. It will show you all the data, and it will also show the store histogram, median, and all of that. You can download all of that. Okay. Marks, point, grid means marks, response, their responses. Let me download one and you can open this. You can open this and you can see the marks. Let me, if I have to show you the Excel, I have to change the screen share, so no problem. I'll just do it for a while. Now, can you see the Excel sheet? So Rakesh, when he has started, when he has ended, how much time he has taken to do the test and how much marks he has got. Could you see that? All the data you can download for free. Okay. Let me stop sharing. And let me go back to the TestMos. This is all about TestMos. I told you the drawbacks is, the drawbacks are 50 questions per test. Only 100 students can take the test. That's all. Else it's a beautiful tool, completely free. All right, so let me go to the next one. The next one that I'm going to talk about is Google Forms. So Google Forms, some of us may be using it. I'll try to tell you more features, okay? So forms. If I want to directly access forms.google.com. Let me click on forms.google.com. All right, so let me open a blank form to show you from scratch. You use forms for two things. Number one, you want to do some surveys. I mean, like poll, you want to ask a question, you want to get answers. You do not want to mark them. You just want to know the opinion. This is called as surveys or polls. You can just simply give a question, give the answers, and they can submit. Number two, as teachers, we use it for assessment. So I will talk from the point of view of assessment. So give it a name first. So ICT test demo WB. Okay. So 1137. Okay. Let me try to control C. Yeah. That's okay. Auto. Right. You can give a description if you wish. So test on ICT. All right. So before I start giving questions, I said we should do it as a test quiz or test. So for that, click on settings. There are so many things, I'll talk about them. Don't worry. Click on settings. Collect email addresses. If you want, you can collect the email addresses, and you can also limit to one response. So that requires sign in. Respondents means test takers. Students can edit after submit. No, if you click this, they can edit after submit. You don't want that. They can see the summary charts and text responses. Once again, you don't want them to see what someone else has answered. So don't check this. Number one, general. Presentation, he can see the progress bar. Progress bar means, let us say there are 10 questions. He has answered two, it will say 2/10 completed, 8 more remaining, something like that. Shuffle the question order. This is okay for me because 10 questions are there for different students. The order will be different. Else it's not like 1A, 2B. He will share the answers to their friends and they'll copy it. You don't want that to happen. Show link to submit another response. No, you want one student to take the test once. That's it. And you can put a confirmation message. So thanks for the test. Whatever message you want to share it with the students, you can share. After the test, they'll get this message. Thanks for the test. Have a great day. Quizzes. Now make this a quiz. You are doing it for assessment. So you have to make this a quiz. All right. release grade. So yeah, you can release the grade. Just now in the test modes we have seen, after he submits, he can see how many marks he has got that we are doing. Okay. He can see missed questions, point values, marks. If you have any doubt, click on the question mark. You will understand that. Okay. Correct answers, which is correct, which is wrong. You can see. So this is okay. I'm doing it for assessment. So right, save. All right. So let me add the first question. So here you can add question. So already the first question is there. Let me add it once again. Gmeet gives me a free time of dash. Okay, free session time. Okay, let me just put session time of dash minutes. So it's a multiple choice question. So now you can have a short answer. You can have multiple choice. You can have a checkbox, you know, true or false. You can do all of that. Okay, let me show you 2-3 of them. So yeah, so give the answers 40 Gmeet, right? Okay, 60 and 20. Answer key, you have to give the answer. So answer key, Gmeet gives a free session time of dash minutes. How much time? 60 is the answer. So say done. All right. Required means he has to answer all the questions. It's not mandatory because you don't want him to put randomly something, so don't click on this. No problem. Go to add question. Go to the next question. Okay. Now, so like this, you can add the other questions. You can explore this. Now I'm going to tell you, how do I add mathematical expressions into Google Forms? So some of us may not be aware of this. I'll tell you how to do it. Okay. So now our aim is to add mathematical equations. It could be integration, it could be matrices, or it could be a polynomial. Okay, let me show you one or two. So let me solve the following. So math lovers can follow this carefully. Okay, solve the following. So for that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a LaTeX editor called as CodeCox. So CodeCox, CodeCox. Click on that. It will take you to an online LaTeX equation editor. Click on that. You can do so many things. Okay. So right now, let me show you one polynomial to start with. So X, and on your keyboard, you have the six, shift six gives you the upper arrow mark. So X square plus, I'm typing that so that you can see, 2X plus 1. As you type here, you can see that image, you know, X square plus 2X plus 1, that image. So now come down. There are so many ways of copying it. If you love LaTeX, click on LaTeX, copy that. Right now, to put this in Google Forms, I will use the URL. I will use URL. Now copy this URL. Control C. Go back to your Google Forms and solve the following. Next to that, you have an image. Can you see an image there? Click on the image. Upload camera by URL. By URL. Click on it. Paste that URL here. The moment you paste it, you can also see the equation here. Insert this image. Now, just 1 minute, 10 seconds, 5 seconds. Now you can see the question. You can see the question. So it is x plus 1 whole square, right? X square, yeah. So answer is x minus 1. So you can give the options minus 1, 0, 1. As usual, you can give the answer. Yeah, this is how your question looks like. 1 point, that's okay. Let me show you one more math, because most of the people are not aware of how to put math. So once again, let us say you want to put integrals. Okay, now see, there are so many so you have differentials, you have integrals, integrals with limits, without limits. You can do all of that. Let me put integrals here with limits. So let us say integral 0 to 1. Okay, what you want to integrate? So let us say you want to integrate x square. Okay, or I'll just keep it simple, 3x square. 3x square dx. So integral 0 to 1, 3x square dx. Once again, come down. That is your question. URL, control C, and yeah. Solve the following. Same procedure, click on this. By URL, control V, immediately you can see what is going to get inserted. You are satisfied with that? That's okay. So 3x square dx. So what is the answer? X power 3 by 3. So limits you apply 1. So let's give the answer 0. Let's give the answer 1. For example, you know, if you do not put the limits, then you will write, you will get in terms of x cube or x power 4, right? Whatever. Here you will get x cube. So here once again, do the same thing. Go there, x cube, copy it, paste it here. So in the images, let me put x cube for you. Let me go to this for that. So let me simply say x cube and copy this. So if your options also have math, follow the same procedure, control V, insert image. And say one, something. Okay. What is the answer? Answer is, here it is one. So answer. And you're given one mark. That's fine, perfect. So here you have to give something. So let's just leave it as dash, okay? Or you can just put A or something, doesn't matter. Okay, so let's given the answer. Answer key is 1, and then say answer key to 1 and done. Okay, perfect. Right, let's go to the next one. So like this you can add mathematics. Okay, so rest all you can try out. I'll show you one last thing. So math is over. I'll go back to this. So please see, integrals you can put, summations you can put, functions, sine, cos, all of that you can put. Matrices, if you want to put, you can put matrices. I'll just show you one. So 2x2 matrix, so 2, 2, enter the array dimension separated by comma. 2, 2 is okay. So and then begin matrix, end matrix. Don't worry about all of that, just put the numbers. 2 ampersand 3 1 ampersand 2. Now you can see your matrix. Can you see your matrix here? So now simply control A, control C, same thing. Just take this. Find the determinant. I'm intentionally focusing on math because other than that, most of you are aware. I mean, maybe some of you could be aware how to use Google Forms. I'll tell you other features also. So the answer is 2 to 4 minus 3, 1. So 0, 1. So let me give the answer. Answer is 1. Okay. All right. So now, so let us say that your question, your test is over. I mean, you filled the questions. Now you can preview the test. Click on preview the test. So you can see first question, solve the following. Answer is 0. Answer is x cube. And answer is 1. You can do it. So solve the following. X square plus 2x plus 1. You can give the options. Here, I think I missed the option. You can give something. Find the determinant and this one. So you can, the candidate can answer that. Okay. So maybe let me answer it. So Roshan, whatever, at the rate rgukt.ac.a. Let me answer the test. So 3x square, let me answer it correct. And this one, let me answer it wrong. Let me answer it wrong. Let me answer, give me 60 seconds. Let me answer it correct. Submit. You can click on this. It will send you a copy of your responses. Don't worry. Just submit. Thank for the test. Have a great day. You have seen this, right? We have put that message. View score. So you can see I've got 2 out of 4 and right answers, wrong answers, it will show me. That's okay. So once again, code Cox. This is code Cox, right? All right. So let me close this. Let me go back to the test. Let me go back to my test. All right. So you can see responses here. Who all have responded? You can see responses here. Okay. So for all the candidates, you can see, you can analyze the responses. That's okay. Question wise, you can see summary. You can see individual. You can click on next, next, next. It will show you all the responses. That's okay. Now, another thing that I want to share with you is many of us below will be having a doubt. Sir, like test modes, let us say 15 minutes, or I give a test to my students now, it is 11:48 now. I want them to end the test by 12:30. Can I time my test? Can I have a timer? In the sense, can I give a due date for the test? As such, using Google Forms, you cannot do that. I have an add-in for it. We have an add-in for it. Google has provided an add-in for it. Add-on, sorry, not add-in. I'm sorry, add-on for it. And that's called as form limiter. I'll just show you how to do it. So for that, what you have to do is click on these three dots, make a copy. Don't worry about all of this. Come to add-ons. Can you see add-ons here? Come to add-ons, click on the add-ons. What is my aim now? I want to add one add-on to this. What will the add-on do? It will give a due date for the test. In forms, it is not inbuilt. So the name is form limiter. Form limiter. Click on form limiter. Click on, you have to install it. I have already installed it. Okay, so I'll just close this. If you're a first timer, click on this, it will just install. It's just a 10 second process. Close this. Now, where is my add-on? At the top. At the top, we have seen what this is. We have seen the preview. You can customize the theme. Theme is very simple. The background, the entire thing, background color, you can choose. This is about a theme. Now come to add-ons. Click on add-ons. There are two add-ons. I have already two add-ons for me. Right now, I'll talk about form limiter. Before I talk about form limiter, CertifyM is one more add-on which you can use. The purpose is your test takers can take the test. If they get more than 50% or 60%, they will get a certificate directly to their email. This is possible in Google Forms. The add-on is CertifyM. Okay, you can explore this. Right now, let me concentrate on form limiter. So let me click on form limiter. So let me just click on form limiter. Oh, it's not opening right now. Okay, why? What could be the reason? I already have that, right? So it should show. So that's not the reason. Something else could be the reason. It's installed. Let me uninstall it for a while. I'll install it again. The entire process will not take more than 1 minute. Form limiter. So this is the add-on. Install. Now you can install. Just install that. Yeah. Continue. So which account? Yeah, this is my account. Yes, exactly. So I'm also showing you, you know, that it will ask some access, give it access, no problem. Hello. Let it install, just 10, 15 seconds. All right. So that's it. It has installed. Perfect. No problem. Let me close this now. All right. Now let me come to this. Okay. Let me just close this. Now come to add-ons, form limiter, click on form limiter. See set limit earlier for some reason I could not see it. So set limit. Once again, here you can do two things. Right now, I want to set the limit by date and time. I want to put a due date. So select a date today, select a time. So let us say 12:30 we said, right? So PM, so 1 PM. Okay, let us say 1 PM today, 1 PM. The test should close. So one hour, you are giving 1 hour for the students to take this test. So set, save and enable. So when you say save and enable, that's it. It is saved, which means after 1 PM, if your students submit it after 1 PM, they cannot access your test. Form limiter with disable your test automatically. You need not do it. This is very, very important. Okay. Other one is number of form responses. It's not for due date. You are organizing a webinar. Let us say you have you can accommodate only 500 people. You do not want more than 700 responses. Let us assume 700 will respond and 500 only will attend. You don't want 1,000 to respond, 1,000 to register. You have a limitation, Zoom limitation, 500 only. So that time, for your Google form, you just put this number of form responses. So when you do that, once 700 people register, automatically this form will get disabled. So this is one more thing that you can use. But right now, for assessment purposes, I don't use this. So that's it. So this is add-on, this is theme, this is preview, and this is settings. I've shown you all of that. And how do you send this link to your students? Click on send and come to this link. This is the link. You can copy it, or you can shorten the URL, copy that, and share it to your students in WhatsApp or mail or anything. So this is all about Google Forms. So what we have seen today, using Google Forms, any number of questions you can put marks. I have shown you how to put the marks, points for each question, multiple, true or false, all of that. And we also have seen how do we put mathematical equations into your test. Okay, so integrals, polynomials, matrices, whatnot, anything you can put using code blocks. And we also have seen how to time the test, how to limit the test using a form limiter add-on available in Google Forms. All right, so this is all about Google Forms. So now let me talk about the last one. It is a game for you. Okay, it's a gaming assessment. I told you, the assessment should not be monotonous for the students. So it should make them, they are playing a game and they should enjoy every part of it. So for that, there are many of them. I will show you one, Mentimeter. Mentimeter. Once again, you just have to sign in. Free. This is free. You can sign in. Already I have signed in. Your presentations. When you sign up, you can, it will take you to this. Okay. I'll just show you one or two questions. I'll show you how to make the questions, and then let's play this game. Okay. It's a quiz. It has questions. It has the leaderboard, which means it will tell us who is first, who is last, how many marks we have got, all of that it gives. Okay. Let me show you how to make questions. So click on new presentation. Sample questions, create presentation. So multiple choice, you can put multiple choice or select answer, all that you could do. Let me just show you multiple choice. Let me give a question. So on the right side, you can give questions, type, content, customize, give the question. There is some question, I'll give something else. So, okay, Mindomo is an example of, okay, mind map. Yesterday I just mentioned about mind maps, right? So Mindomo is a example of mind map. I've not discussed that, but anyway, just to tell you. So mind map let me say LMS. Two options are enough. So which is the right answer? You have to show correct answer. Click on show correct answer and click on mind map. So you are question paper setter and then you are setting it. Okay. If you want to add the next question, follow the same. True or false, you could do. So select answer, So you can put one more. So Zoom gives 40 minutes, something you can just put. So just say yes. So say yes and or say no. Close this. What's the answer? Answer is yes. So now you can see here time to answer. So you can also time this, let us say 10 seconds. This is a simple question. They should not take more than 5 seconds. So you can put 10 seconds. You can limit the time and you can also put the leaderboard. Leaderboard means after this question, after the answer, it will show me whoever is playing the game. It will show me who has answered fast, all of that. So this is how you can set the questions. So enough, let me go back. And now let me give you a gaming assessment. I'll put a link in the chat box. You please click on the link and take this test. Okay, this has nothing to do with the certificate. This is just to be a part of it. Let me click on the presentation. I'll just share it with you, do not worry, share. Copy link. Where is our Zoom? I'll put it in the chat box. One minute. Okay. Now, one. So, please stop. Please stop the chat. I'm going to put a link here. All of you, please click the link. And I'm going to start this test. I'm going to present this. So on the screen, present will be there. So there could be audio also. You can put music, background music. I'm going to put it. So present. Now you can see the number of candidates as they get into the quiz. You can see at the right bottom corner, 36, 38. So let me add the music. Okay, let's start the test. The first question. I've given 15 seconds time. So these are the answers that have come. No problem. Let's go to the next one. So the correct answer is Zoom for this. Let's go to the next question. It is showing you the leaderboard. So right now, Mr. Kallalji is at the top. So let's see if someone else will overcome him in the next question or not. So let's go to the next question. Next one, fastest speaker first. More points. You have to answer fast. So leaderboard. Right now, Maumita ji is at the top. Let's see whether someone else would cross him. So let's go to the next question. Yeah, please answer this. The following is an example of whiteboard. OneLens, Miro, Cisco WebEx. Which is an example of whiteboard? Okay, let's go to the next one. So yeah, next question. The following are free assessment platforms. All right. 42 have responded. Great. Okay. 45. Yeah. So So the winner of today's session is Mr. Devajit ji. Congratulations, Devajit Sen Sharma ji. Anyway, all right, so that's all about Mentimeter, Kahoot, Nearpod, Mentimeter, Quizalize. All of these are gaming assessment platforms. Yesterday I've shown you, I've listed out what all are available. So we have seen one of them, Mentimeter. Rest all also would look similar. You will have background music, you will have questions, you will have, you know, like this, you can add this thing. You can see the scores and you can see the leaderboard. You can add leaderboard. So this is like a gamification. Okay. So to just make assessment more interesting and interactive. Okay. Like a game. So that's it from my side. Microsoft Forms. I thought I could discuss Microsoft Forms, but we don't have time. No problem. I'll try to make a video on it and then I can share it. So that's all from my side. So what all we have discussed today's session, we have talked about the presentation tools, Prezi and Microsoft PPT. And we have talked about the video recording tools offline and online, right? We have seen APowerSort, we have seen Zoom, and we have seen OBS. Live streaming, don't worry, I'll send you a video, okay? And we also have seen assessment platforms, Testmos, and Google Forms. Little in-depth we have done, how to put math, how to put time limit, etc. And Mentimeter, you know, how to make the assessments more like a game, okay? Kahoot, Nearpod, Quizalize. So these are the alternatives for gaming assessments. So that's all from my side. So if there are any questions, so let me take them. Right. Oh, congratulations, Devashree ji, got second question. That's okay. Sir, in Testmos, do the students write long? A good question. So once again, your answer, it should match your answer. So better, you know, don't put that, or else you have to manually, you know, evaluate it. So you could do that, manual evaluation. Any other questions? Yeah, Kahoot, I told you, right? Kahoot, Mentimeter, Nearpod, Quizalize, all of them same. Yeah. Yeah, fun. It's meant for fun. No. Okay. Like time, can we fix a date in Testmos? Testmos date. I don't think you can put, sir. No. Free users cannot put that. Okay. If any question require any diagram, how can student attach it in Google Form? I have shown you, right? Next to question, how did we attach the CodeCog equation using a diagram only, right? If you just want me to show you, just it will take only 1 minute. Let me just open the same form for a while so that becomes clear to you. So click on the question. Now can you see next to the question there is a picture? Click on that. Let me use it by Google Image Search. It's a Google Meet question, right? So Gmeet. Let me choose this image. Let me insert it. Yeah, could you see that? So the image that you wanted, Gmeet gives a free session. So something related to Gmeet, I have put the image also. You could preview that also. I have randomized the question, so it is here. So like that, you can, yeah, put insert images. Yeah. Okay. What else? Any other questions? Yeah. Absolutely okay. Padmavati ji, 1000. Absolutely okay. You can do any amount. No problem. Google Form is, it'll take it. Yeah. At Testmos, can we share the test link via email? No. Yeah, you can share it via WhatsApp also. Only link you have to send. They can take the test. Yeah, you can do it. If students have to insert images. Students have to insert images. Yeah, they can do it, but at Google. So if it is a
will be wrong.
You can do it like, but it has to be like something like assignment. You know, then they can insert, because for a quiz you don't expect them to insert images. No, I mean generally, because you are giving marking. If it is for survey thing, you can do it. If you are taking exam in Google Classroom, can we Google Classroom? Yesterday I have not purposefully highlighted Google Forms because today we are doing it. Yeah, if we are taking exam in Google Classroom, can we give MCQ and told them to choose any 15 or 10 out of 15? No, you can say that, but the marking would be a problem. So that so he will mark it out of 15 questions. So that is a little difficult. If you can evaluate it manually, you want to do it, you can do that. So that option is not there as such. You have to answer it straight away. Is there any platform exists where we do present, record, whiteboard, classrooms, and yeah, you can do all of this. Microsoft Teams, you can do it. Microsoft Teams, Cisco WebEx Teams, You can do that, but it's costlier. All of it one place, you will not get it for free. Subhajit ji, Microsoft Teams, you can do that. Present, yeah. You can record, yes. Whiteboard is there. Classrooms, yeah. It's LMS, basically it's LMS. And assessment, it's there, yeah. Direct assessment is not there once again. You can assess it, yeah, no problem. Google Classroom to a certain extent is yes. Request to share the video. Okay, see, I can, I'll share the video. I'll share the video, no problem. So what I'll do is, so give me 1 minute. Copy. So right now, let me just, so with the permission of the organizers, I'm just putting one feedback form. It's only for resource person. So I just wanted to know how you built it. I'm not collecting anything, only your name, email, your college, and only two questions are there. Please answer it at your own time. You can copy this link, put it somewhere. You can answer now, you can answer later. It has nothing to do with the certificate. Sure. Okay. So this is for me only. So please give your honest answers. You can do it later also, no hurry. Okay. So please note it down and then I'll open the chat box. So yeah, Sandeep ji, Kalol ji, Suraj ji, I'm done from my side. Anything else is there? I'll take the questions. Yeah.
Okay, sir. Just a minute. Yeah, thank you so much. I'd like to say that this session has been a wonderful one and in fact has exceeded our expectations as well as that of the listeners and the participants, I feel. So personally, I'd like to thank you. I have learned a lot from you personally. I'd like to practice those with the help of your videos. So with this brief note of thanks, I'd like to invite Dr. Shondeep Pal, Assistant Professor, Department of Zoology of Barakpur Rashtriya Shubhnath College and the convener of this of this program to deliver the vote of thanks. Shondeep, it's over to you.
Yes. Thank you, Kalolda. Am I audible, na?
Yes, you're audible.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, on behalf of Barakpur Rashtriya Shubhnath College and all the participants, I would like to thank our invited speaker, Yeshchad Rakesh Roshanji, for his wonderful deliberations in this two-day professional development program for teachers on applications of ICT in the new normal teaching and learning. I hope his lucid and detailed presentation on various ICT-related tools such as whiteboard, video conferencing, LMS yesterday, and presentation, video recording and assessment tools today enrich all of us and will definitely help us to getting adapted to this new normal mode of teaching and learning. I express my gratitude to Honorable President Sir, Governing Body of this college for his gracious presence in this program. Thanks are due to our respected Principal Sir, Dr. Monojit Roy, for his constant support and encouragement. I would also like to thank ICAC Coordinator Madam for his for this college of this college for her pivotal keynote address which set the program in motion. Organizing any event is a teamwork and it becomes easy when you have a colleague like Sri Kallol Shah, the joint convener, Dr. Suraj Sheikh, the organizing secretary of this event, and of course our technical expert, Sri Sudipto Sarkar. Finally, on behalf of this college, I would like to thank in-house and other participants from all over India who took part actively in this program and raised numerous questions in this engaging topic. Hope to see you all in the future events organized by our college. So thank you all. I think feedback form link is already given in the chat box.
No, actually, Shondeep, I'd like to request Sudipto to enable the chat box. The chat box has been disabled, actually.
I'll just do that. Actually, I had disabled it so that.
Okay.
I'm just doing it. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
I've just done that.
Hello,
thank you. Available now.
Thank you to the organizers, and thank you, Mr. Rakesh Roshan. It was a wonderful presentation.
Feedback form is given. Feedback form is given.
Yeah. The feedback form has been given. Sandeep, you please check the feedback form has been given.
Yeah, it's given. Okay, maybe one more thing from my side. If someone is interested, you know, I can share the YouTube link. You need not subscribe it. I'm not doing it for this thing. If you want to, you know, whenever I have time, I'll put some new things into it related to ICT only.
Sure, you can.
You can do that.
Sure. Yeah, you can. Sure.
I am not interested in publicizing at all. But since some of the OBS and all, I could not discuss Microsoft Forms. I'll put some of them, and I'll be putting more of them. You can go to this, and then you can see already some things are available. I'll put few more things in the near future. So I've just started this 3 months back, just the sole intent of helping out the fellow faculty throughout the country. So yeah, please go ahead and please explore these tools. I'm sure whatever we have discussed, you know, if you explore them in detail, and I made sure that, you know, at a personal level, you know, most of it is free, okay, freely available, and I try to give the best available tools. Okay, so please go through them, please explore them, and have a great time. And please see that your students get the best as they used to during the traditional mechanism. So thank you once again.
One thing, Mr. Rakesh Roshan.
Yes.
Actually, I just wanted to mention that you were talking about publicizing. I would like to say that once you have the material in you, you don't need to publicize yourself. Listeners, the participants, it's people like us who will be publicizing you.
Generally, absolutely. What people could, thank you for that, but generally what people could think is, if you put some YouTube link and all, now I want subscribers and all, I'm least bothered
not
about
at all,
it.
Not at all.
Yeah, it is just too.
At least not in your case. At least not in your case.
Thank you.
Yes. Yeah. So formally, I think Sandeep, Suraj and ma'am, we are at the end of this session, and the ma'am, with your kind permission, should we call this session as closed?
Yes, sure. And I would like to thank the resource person a lot, because without him, it would not have been possible for us to have such a fantastic session. Thank you so much. I thank Principal Sir, President Sir, and all the participants, and all my colleagues. I thank Sandeep, I thank Suraj, I thank Kollur, without, and also Sudipto. It has been a fantastic session, and thank you so much, sir, again.
Thank you, ma'am. My pleasure, yeah.
So for the participants, the link will remain open up to 12:30. The meeting room will be open up to 12:30. You can fill it from the chat box itself, or you can just copy the link and paste it somewhere and do it in say an hour. We'll be keeping the link open for an hour. And the chat and the meeting room will be open for up to 12:30.
Thank you very much, sir.
For today. Yeah.
Okay, so I'll take leave of you. So take care. Have a great day.
Sure.
Take care.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I'm leaving. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Sure.
Okay. Sure.
51 feedbacks have been submitted already. 51.
Sir, feedback submitted.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Sir, Olumkrita.
Okay, we have received it. Thank you.
Okay,
sir. Yeah. Hello, मैंने भी send कर दिया है.
Okay, Vikram.
ठीक है, ठीक है.
धन्यवाद सर.
Sir, feedback submitted. Mayuk Debna.
Okay. Thank you, Mayuk. Sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank
sir,
you.
Feedback submitted.
Can I leave, sir?
Okay. Yeah, sure.
Yes.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Once the participants have done the feedback submission, they may please leave the platform. Thanks to all. Thank you.
Kalal sir, feedback form submitted. Thank you.
Thank you, Shoikar sir.
Eric, can you see photo? Can you see
feedback submitted, Kalal da.
Yeah, thank you.
Photo can you see this? How can you see
this? Submitted, Kalal.
Okay, thank you.
Suraj and Sandeep.
Okay, thank you.
You WhatsApp it then.
Kalal sir, Rupam bol feedback form submit kore diyechi.
Okay, thik ache Rupam da.
Iski sab le ek sath.
Gir jayega
sir? Ha ha.
Bas ho gaya.
Ek Kalal la.
Aapne do number
hai. Okay.
Nahi mera ek
hi
hai. Kahan do?
Ja.
Yes, sure.
বলছি ফিডব্যাক ফর্ম
ইউপি
হ্যাঁ লাভ আছে
কি বলে আচ্ছা ইউপি
রাও তৈয়ার তো
সন্দীপ এতগুলো ভয়েস আছে একসাথে
হ্যাঁ ওটাই
ও সন্দীপ
এই
তো यार
হ্যাঁ সন্দীপ কথা বলো না তাহলে শোনা যাবে না কিছু एक्चुअली কিছু বুঝিয়ে দাও বলো
ফিডব্যাক টেস্ট নেই একটু দেখো না
ফিডব্যাকটা एक्चुअली কলম না চেক করছি ফিডব্যাকটা কলম না চেক করছি
ओके
सुदीप सोदा सुदीप
बोलोल सर मेरा फीडबैक गया है विक्रम
आ जाएगा
हां हो जाएगा सुदीप सोदा सुदीप सोदा के पास है हो जाएगा
बोलोल दा
हां
फीडबैक दी दी जी देख तो
ऐसा सुदीप सोदा देखछे
समस्या की
विद यू परमिशन कॉल Sandeep and Suresh bhai, may I leave for today? Okay, you can leave, Shagatta.
Thank you, Suresh bhai. Thank you, Kalal, and thanks a lot, Sandeep bhai.
Hello.
Sir, please check my feedback.
94 feedback.
Kitara.
94.
What is it? আরেকটা দিন হতো ইয়ে করে ভালো করে ক্লাস করলে
হ্যালো
সুমিতা দি বলো
হ্যাঁ বলছি আমার ফিডব্যাকটা সাবমিট হয়েছে আমি করলাম
হ্যাঁ সুদীপ্ত দা একবার একটু বলে দিও না দেখে
সুদীপ্ত দা চেক করে দেখো
সাকসেসফুলি সাবমিট করলে হয়ে যায় কোনো প্রবলেম হয় না
সন্দীপ
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ সুনীতা বলছে
আচ্ছা সুদীপ তো বলবে
হ্যাঁ
হ্যাঁ আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে
হলল মোছরা খান
ওরে বাবা
মোছরা ঠিক
আছে ভেরি নাইস
বিক্রম
হ্যাঁ
বিক্রম কে দেখো
মোছরা খান পুরো টাকলা হয়ে গেছে
I heard someone from outside India.
বিক্রম আর একবার দেখা দে
বলো না সুমিতা দাকে একটু বলো না সুমিতা দিকটা
সুমিতা দি একটু জানতে চাইছে জমা পড়লো কিনা
অবশ্যই জমা পড়বে আবদুল্লাহ শুধু ডক্টর লিখে ছেড়ে দিয়েছে পুরোটা লেখেনি
আচ্ছা আমাদের একজন এক্সটারনাল পার্টিসিপেন্ট ভূপেন্দ্র দিওয়ার তারটা হয়েছে কিনা উনি জিজ্ঞেস করছেন অনেকক্ষণ ধরে
হ্যাঁ ওই ভূপেন্দ্র দিওয়ার তোরা দেখো তো
ভূপেন্দ্র দিওয়ার
আছে অব আসবে তো অবশ্যই কোন
হ্যাঁ
হ্যাঁ নরম
চ্যাটে তো আসছে না
এই যে দিচ্ছি দিচ্ছি
চলে আসবে দেখো দেওয়া
হয়েছে দেখো চলে
গেছে
হ্যাঁ আসছে
This is Victor Mukherjee from Niwalipur College. Please check that whether I have already submitted. Please confirm me.
Okay, we are checking.
What name?
Normally, it should get submitted. I mean, you can rest assured there is no other technical problem. But let's see. We can check.
What name?
This is Victor Mukherjee. Victor Mukherjee.
Victor Mukherjee.
Victor Mukherjee.
Kololda?
Yes.
কাউকে কাউকে চেক করতে হবে না যারটা সাবমিট হয়ে যাবে সে সার্টিফিকেট পেয়ে যাবে তার মেইল বক্স চেক করতে হবে তাহলেই হবে
yeah that is what I was telling if you see that your form has been submitted then you can assume that it is submitted and you just check for the certificate in the next 5-10 minutes
okay thank you
Anamika ma'am have you completed the feedback
হয়ে গেছে সাবমিট
যে মিস্টার রাকেশ রোশন উনি একটা ফিডব্যাক লিংক দিয়েছিলেন সেটা পেলাম না তো
সেটা আছে দেখো আছে আচ্ছা অপরদিক আছে
না না মোটা মাছ বিষয় যেটা বেরিয়ে গিয়েছিল পাবেন আমি আবার দিয়ে দিচ্ছি আমি আবার দিয়ে দাও তো হ্যাঁ জাস্ট আমি
বিষয় দা
বলো
কেমন লাগলো একটু ভার্বাল ফিডব্যাক দাও দেখি
খুব ভালো ভীষণ ভীষণ এফেক্টিভ এই এনাকে এনাকে কি তুমি
ওই
আগে পড়ে কথা হবে
বিশ্বদা
বলো
হ্যাঁ বিশ্বদা
হ্যাঁ বলো
এই তো এনাকে আর কি আমরা আমি আর সন্দীপ এনারা লেকচার আগে শুনেছিলাম এরকম সেখানে আমাদের দুজনের খুবই ভালো লাগে
আচ্ছা
দিয়ে তারপর আমরা দুজন মিলে ঠিক করে নিই যে মানে এনাকে আনতে হবে দিয়ে তারপর ওনার সাথে কন্টাক্ট করি বুঝছো
হ্যাঁ
উনি রাজি হয়ে যান দিতে স্যারের সাথে কথা বলে তারপরে ঠিক করা হয়
খুব ভালো
আই না সিস্টেমটা সত্যি মানে মানে এক্সিলেন্ট মানে পুরো মোচ্চে হাতে করে দেখিয়ে দিচ্ছেন একদম পুরো মানে একবারে সেই বোরিং লেকচারের থেকে মানে দেখানো ই করা সেটাই বেশি ভালো ইনি সেটাই করান
এই সময় এটা খুব দরকারও ছিল আর
এটা তো অবশ্যই দরকার ছিল একটা মানে আমরা কিভাবে কি করব না করব পুরোপুরি দেখিয়ে দিয়েছেন
আগামী 6 মাস ধরে এইভাবেই তো চলবে
আর
বিশ্বদা স্পিকারের লিংকটা দিয়ে দিয়েছি
দেখছি হ্যাঁ
আর এখানে পার্টিসিপেন্টস আছে টোটাল 20
লিপ করছি
ওকে ওকে হ্যাঁ ঠিক আছে ঠিক আছে থ্যাংক ইউ
Hello, I am Dr. Arindam Rai. Till now, I am not getting certificate to my email, Gmail. Hello.
হ্যাঁ হয়ে গেছে থ্যাংক ইউ অল আমি বেরিয়ে গেলাম হ্যাঁ
ওকে বিশ্বজিৎ So in another 2 minutes, we'll be closing the meeting room. Participants who may not have filled up the feedback form, may please do it in another 2 minutes. We'll be closing the meeting room.
Kolol da, thale leave kore jacchi. Okay, leave kore gelam.
আমার কাজ বাজেও না
আচ্ছা হ্যালো 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 হ্যালো
হ্যাঁ বলুন বলুন বলুন
হ্যালো
হ্যাঁ বলুন
বলছি আই এম ডক্টর অরিন্দম রায় টিল নাও আই এম নট গেটিং দ্য সার্টিফিকেট ইন মাই জিমেইল আর কি
ওকে ইউ ক্যান গেট গেট শর্টলি ইউ ক্যান গেট ইট শর্টলি ওকে
ওকে ওকে
বন্ধ করে দেবে
কি বলছো
জুমটা অফ হ্যাঁ বলছি এবার জুমটা অফ করে দেবে
হ্যাঁ জুমটা অফ করে দিচ্ছি কিন্তু তোমার ইয়েটা একটু খুলে রাখো
তোমার গ্রুপটা খুলে দি
হোয়াটসঅ্যাপ গ্রুপটা খুলে রাখো আর তোমার লিংকটাকে তোমার কাছে রাখো যদি কেউ বলে যে পাইনি তাহলে দিয়ে দেবে ঠিক আছে কারণ 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 একটু সমস্যার জন্য সার্টিফিকেট অফ হয়ে গিয়েছিল সার্টিফিকেট যায়নি এখন যারা করছে পাচ্ছে প্লাস যারা আগে করে তারাও পেয়ে যাবে এটা নিয়ে কোনো সমস্যা নেই
আচ্ছা আচ্ছা
ঠিক আছে সার্টিফিকেট তো পেয়ে যাবে
ঠিক আছে
ওকে
তাই হ্যাঁ গ্রুপটা খোলা রাখছি শুধু
হ্যাঁ গ্রুপ খোলা রাখছি আমি মিটিং মিটিং রুম এন্ড করে দিচ্ছি
হ্যাঁ করে দাও ঠিক আছে
ওকে ওকে